keys to our worm food, or else we're all gonna be worm food.
Just stick to the plan, Ryan. Hold your ground.
Don't just sit there. At least put some shots down range.
That's me, Ryan. All you really need to know right now is that I have no idea what I'm doing. This is Joe, short for G.I. Joe, which people call him to mock his excess enthusiasm for all things military. I'd say he has a particular dislike for me, but I think he just likes yelling at everybody. That's Maps, sweet girl, but a little too into her plans and strategy, if you ask me. Then there's Lieutenant. He's all about following orders. Can be a bit controlling, but makes a good team leader. And then, that brings us back to me. My mom says I've always wanted to be a soldier in the military. Pew pew! That's me as a kid. Problem is, I've never really been what you would call a disciplined person. Or a fast learner. Or good at anything, really. My dad, who hangs drywall for a living, won't even take me to work anymore. He says I always manage to put holes in his new walls. I always just say he needs to make walls out of stronger stuff. So when the Sarge recruited me to join a new training program for high school students wanting to join the Air Force, you can imagine how surprised and excited I was. I know what you're thinking. I said soldier, not a pilot. Turns out the Air Force has a number of combat-ready roles. Besides, didn't you ever watch Stargate? Anyway, they also tend to lead the way in military technology. And the Sarge is testing a new experimental training technology that is supposed to be able to train anyone, which is why I think I was chosen. Apparently, I'm anyone. How does this technology work? It's hard to describe. Here's how Sarge explained it.
Each of you have been specifically selected to be in our new boot camp program. You might try to have guessed what boot stands for.
Ballet Ocarina of Time? Band opera over there? Maybe we all camp inside of boots instead of tents, like the old lady who lived in a shoe. Maybe we all have to wear boots everywhere. Gosh, I hope they are high heel boots. High heel boots are great for my figure. There's a snake in my boot. Maybe Sarge is Canadian, he's really saying bout camp. But then what would bout camp stand for? Babies oscillate under tires? Bad olives utter treason?
You'd be wrong.
Did I say that out loud? Oh no, did I say that out loud?
Basic Operation Overwrite Training. Are you confused, soldier?
No. No, sir. Yes, sir.
Clearly. Drop down and give me 20.
The main difference in your training is I will be accessing your brain more directly with a new technology known as RED, which stands for Retinal Electronic Discipline. Too many acronyms for you, soldier?
Yes, sir? No, sir.
Acronym. What's an acronym? It must be military lingo for push-ups.
I could do acronyms all day. I'm an acronym expert. All day long.
You keep using that word. I don't think it means what you think it means.
You may be the new kid, but I expect you to keep up.
The good news is, with the RED interface, even you will be performing at a high rate, more than you would even imagine. Maybe even tomorrow.
Was that funny, soldier?
No, sir. Yes, it is. I'm hilarious when I want to be. Dismissed.
Yes, sir!
Go to the RED room.
That was yesterday, so here I am, headed for my session for the RED interface. Let's see how this goes.
You ready for this dog meat? This is gonna hurt.
Don't listen to him. You're gonna be all right.
The retinal connection is quite innocuous.
All right, future airmen, today's training program is uploaded
and I'm here set in the control room. Is everybody ready to boot up?
Sir, yes, sir!
Airman Ryan, this is a digital training ground. I will be uploading training information that, if you allow it, will help you make decisions on the battlefield. This isn't a video game, it's a serious training program.
Is that spinning thing a respawn point?
Yes.
Awesome.
But don't get any crazy ideas. You can only run as fast and jump as far as your brain knows you can. So no super strength or mind over matter stuff. Okay, here's your first training downloads. It'll help you handle your weapons.
Oh, cool!
What are you doing, maggot brain? The enemy's gonna know where we are.
Shouldn't I know not to do that?
The Sarge can only upload so much training at a time, or it'll fry your brain. And common sense does apply in these exercises.
Provided you have any.
Besides, the training is just a guide. You still have to make the right choices with it. Alright, let's move out before she gets here.
Who is she?
She's our chief adversary and my arch enemy.
Joe, why do you always have to be so melodramatic?
Your face is melodramatic.
Do you know what that means? What? I don't know what it means either.
Maps, what do you got?
Alright, so to my best calculations, we're about here, and best place for an ambush would be about here.
Sure you don't need to consult your backpack again, Dora?
Oh.
I could sneak around this ridge and take him out with my knife.
Hey!
What are you gonna do? Cut through it like...
Knock it off, you two. The Sarge says we have to work together.
You don't have to be such a kiss-up, you know.
Well, we all can't be Mr. G.I. Joe, can we?
I'm one of a kind.
That's for sure.
Say that to my face and I'll send you back to the spawn point faster than you can say, accident.
That's enough, you two. Let's follow the plan that Sarge gave us.
Guys, there's no one up ahead. I think we should just...
Oh! Shots fired!
Go, go, go! Really hurt.
Move your keister, worm food, or else we're all gonna be worm food.
Just stick to the plan, Ryan. Hold your ground.
Don't just sit there. At least put some shots down range.
Congratulations.
Oh man. Okay, now what do I do? Go back, sneak up, go around, run?
Alright, sorry about that guys. I'm here. What's the plan? Wait. Why are you guys here?
Because she snuck around behind us!
She has?
Respawn. Okay, this time I'll be coming at her team from behind. Oh, this is perfect cover. It should give me a wide open shot. Wait, what are they doing? Oh, not again.
Oh, worst decision ever.
I'll say,
But there is good news. Looks like you're finally worth an actual bullet. You've been so terrible. Red hasn't even wasted a bullet on you. Until now.
That's enough for today. Looks like you all need a lot more basic training.
I have you right where I want you. Then you'll know the true meaning of fear.
Evil laugh while you're still chewing your food. You know what happened last time. Are you choking? Are you bleeding?
No, mother.
Do I need to get your EpiPen?
No, mother. No, no.
What about your ointment?
No,
you
mother.
You got that rash still on your hiney?
No, mother. That happened 3 days ago.
Marcus, I'm coming down with your EpiPen.
No, no, you really don't. You really don't.
Mama's coming.
No, you really don't.
Mama's coming. No, Pulp Fiction.
Let me explain this one more time. Ryan's lack of training does not excuse the rest of you from your poor performance. I had uploaded instructions to the three of you on how to assist a new recruit. But you were so focused on yourselves, you didn't use your training. Let this be a reminder to you all that there's a large difference between knowing what to do and letting the knowledge guide you in your actions. Now let's talk about today's training program.
Sarge? Ryan apparently encountered Wolf towards the end of the program, sir.
Are you sure? I didn't notice anyone hacking into our system.
I don't know who Wolf is, but he didn't attack me, but he mocked me pretty heavily.
So you're describing the rest of your team.
Stuff a grenade in it, Joe.
What did he look like?
Dressed in black with an odd mask, and his voice was all distorted.
Interesting.
Sir?
Now, Wolf was the original recruit for Sarge's program. But he kicked him out. He was a punk.
He was completely selfish and refused to work with the team.
More than a lone wolf. I get the name now.
Now there's a rival company trying to take my technology, and they've hired him to do it.
Anyway, I just thought you should know, sir.
Kiss up.
Thank you, soldier. I will try and increase the setting on the firewall. We are running out of time. I'll brief you in program. Go boot up. Godspeed. This is a hostage rescue scenario. Not only do you have to infiltrate and eliminate, but you have to extract the hostage unharmed as well. Perhaps you should come up with a plan and stick with it this time. I'm uploading the friend or foe recognition program, as well as some close quarter combat.
I've got a plan, so let's take some time and follow it.
That's what you always say.
But that's never what we actually do.
You're right. Let's do our best. And let's stick to the plan this time.
Remember, proper previous planning prevents poor performance. What? It was in one of the downloads they gave me yesterday. It just popped into my head.
So what is this brilliant plan?
From the layout here, I think I've come up with the perfect strategy. There are two enemies here. And reinforcements will come through these stairs. Now stick to the plan.
Today, Satan.
shooting.
Guys?
Don't worry about it.
But shouldn't we...
Don't worry. She has us under control.
Well, I know, but...
Just stick to the plan, Blood Splatter.
Blood Splatter?
Well, yeah, that's what you're gonna spend most of the day being. Blood Splatter.
No thanks.
Where'd she go?
Isn't that her gun?
So far.
Yep, now on to phase two.
Alright, let's clear the room and save the hostage.
You know Red is going to be in there, so let's do this by the book.
Three, two, one.
Just you, me, and the hostage left. You don't have specific training for this scenario. Can you figure out what to do? I'm not gonna wait long enough for them to come rescue you, or the hostage. I'll give you till the count of 10, and then I'm going to come out and finish you off. 10, 9, 8,
Tyler.
7, 6, 5,
hope this works.
4, 3,
so much tension.
2, 1. That's all you get.
Did you get her?
Sure looks like it.
Well, even Scooby-Doo catches criminals. Doesn't mean he knows what he's doing.
Do you even hear yourself?
I like Scooby-Doo, just like Mama always said.
You're not helping. Now let's hurry up and grab the hostage and go. Yeah, the enemies respawned also.
Come with me if you want to live.
About time you guys got here.
Fun's over. See you tomorrow at the debrief.
Why did she say that she'd see us at the debrief?
Oh yeah, because Sarge controls Red in the program.
Wait, so she's him. No, he's her. That's a little weird, right?
Yeah.
Are you saying a woman isn't an intimidating opponent?
No, not at all. Actually, a woman who can do that is probably an even more intimidating opponent, almost like Tomb Raider. Have you ever played that game?
Yeah, Tomb Raider's great.
Why was Wolf there again? And this time, in the middle of the program.
Well, he's gotta be getting closer to the source code.
Can't the Sarge just change the passcode?
not like it's Facebook or something.
Sarge designed the program to interface on a very complex and personal level. To make it more secure would make it harder for us to use.
And if Sarge wants to get this program out to the whole world, this whole thing has a lot more applications than just the military.
And why is he worried about someone trying to steal it?
Wolf wants to destroy Sarge's code and keep one for himself.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Didn't even touch you.
It was good thinking outside the box, but you may have hit the hostage as well.
But my plans were good, weren't they, sir?
Yes, Maps, plans are good, but you can't plan for everything. I have you train and practice so that when situations come up, it comes second nature to you.
They are part of who you are. The next scenario is designed to test that.
I've set up a terrorist cell in an encampment and beyond these trees up here.
There'll be a force in the woods and a large force at the camp, where there is a lot of open ground, so beware. Also, due to the heightened security measures, I've changed the parameters for this program. Once you are dead, you'll be logged out of the program. No respawning by you or the enemy.
Once everyone dies on one side or the other, we'll do it again, and again, and again. Boot up.
So what's the plan?
You heard Sarge. We don't need a plan. We need guns.
That's not what he said.
Tell you what. You go make a plan, I'm gonna sneak around and go Chuck Norris on people.
Let's try it. At least for a round.
I'll see you losers in a bit.
But who knows, it might work. But what's the worst that'll happen?
Sounds good. Let's boot up.
We already booted up.
Never mind, I was just trying to sound cool.
So long.
Yes, you're amazing.
What's your body count up to? I've taken out 8.
3?
I've got 2. And do you really expect us to believe you got up to 8? We're gonna find out the truth in debriefing.
Well, I think it was 8. I might have lost track.
I know. Counting's just so hard.
Well, to be fair, it was the smoothest mission so far.
Oh yeah, where is Lieutenant?
Maybe that's him now.
Don't shoot. I have to talk to you guys.
There's a virus in the program.
What kind of virus?
Wolf has set it up so that if any of you log out, it'll do permanent neurological damage to the ones left in.
What?
But the person who logged out would be alright, right?
Seriously?
Well, I was just asking.
Well, what's that going to accomplish?
He can't get the source code directly, but if he gets all 4 of you together, he'll have enough pieces to put it together.
So, we'll all just log out at the same time?
I'm afraid Wolf has captured the lieutenant, so he can't log himself out.
Can't you just log us all out at the same time from the control room?
Not with the virus doing its damage.
And even worse, the virus is going to cause an automatic reboot of the system in an hour, with all of you still in it.
Is that bad?
Let's just say, it's not going to be good for your mental health.
So you'll be okay, Joe.
This just got real.
And Wolf has control of all the programmed enemies.
So we're gonna have to rescue the lieutenant, aren't we?
Yes. And of course, it's a trap.
Well, at least we've got you.
Never liked gingers anyway.
Does that mean that Sarge is gonna have brain damage?
Don't worry. Your precious Sarge is fine. He didn't have an interface like yours. Can't say the same for you. Surrender at the main camp enclosure, or you'll be all sharing a padded room. I've sent guards to make sure you come unarmed. If you don't, they have orders to kill. I'll lose my coding, but you will lose more. See you soon.
I don't understand. How could one guy get a drop on Lieutenant and Red just like that?
There's something else we haven't told you.
What?
Wolf wasn't just another recruit.
And he didn't leave because he couldn't hack it.
He was the first recruit.
He was better than all of us.
What are we gonna do? We need a plan.
We don't have time for a plan.
I've got an idea. Maps, I think you're gonna like this plan. Joe, you get to use your skills. And if we pull this off, it'll be a feat of teamwork that both the Lieutenant and Sarge will be proud about.
It's time to lock and load!
Yeah!
got you back.
Accomplished by all this. You try to torture me? We can feel pain in this program, but not that much pain.
Not hardly. I expect you to sit quietly and be the bait I brought you here to be.
When Sarge realizes what you've done, he'll just log me out.
I'm sure he'd like to, but I've embedded a virus into the system that exploits your interconnectedness. If one of you logs out, the others will be... let's just say there would be mental repercussions.
You're a monster.
Or a genius?
A monster.
Or a genius?
Monster!
Genius?
Monster!
You are right, of course. I am a monster. But here's the really scary part. I'm more accomplished than you. I received the most training in your boot camp. You live in my shadow. I am the best version of you. So if I'm a monster, what does that make you? Ah, there are your friends, right on time. More mini-monsters following in my footsteps.
Hey, I've only got one bullet left.
I've got enough problems here. You're on your own.
At the rally point. Where are you mud people at?
I'm headed to the rendezvous point.
This is great. Now we just have to wait till dark.
Anyone order a hot cup of Joe?
I would applaud, but I need this hand to force you to drop your weapons.
Defeat.
You really did do a great job. You've learned a lot, but not enough. Even if you shoot me, you know I'll still be able to pull this trigger, doing irreparable brain damage to each one of you.
I guess we really never did have a shot, did we?
Well, no. But of course, you had to try.
Of course.
I'm sure you think you have a trick up your sleeve, but I've thought of every contingency. I'm smarter, faster, and well, just better than the rest of you. No amount of programming is going to train you to operate at my level. That's the real flaw of the Sarge's system.
Actually, I think that's the genius of it. And that's why you're going to lose.
Enlighten me.
Yes, you are better than us. Yes, you were the first person on here. Yes, you have a cool face mask. Yes, you are more physically fit than all of us, especially no names. But still, the boot camp is not about just making better versions of ourselves.
That's exactly what it does.
With someone like you, yes, but take someone like Joe.
Yeah, I mean, I'm strong and I train hard, but not a lot of people like me. So I'm just really glad that Sarge chose me, and I couldn't have done this alone.
Or me. Like, I can come up with a really good plan, and I can wrap my head around a map better than most people. But without the boot camp, like, I would be way too cautious. I would never be able to step out of my comfort zone.
Yeah, if I didn't have this program, I'd be so caught up in getting approval from other people, it would just control my life.
And then there's me. Sure, I'm not as smart as Maps, not as strong as Joe, and I can't quite lead like Lieutenant. But we're still gonna beat you.
If this is a winning, I think you're confused. In 2 minutes, I'll have what I want.
You only see who we've been. You don't see who we are, and certainly you don't see who we're going to be. That's the Sarge's real gift. He's willing to risk his reputation, his program, and everything for all these misfits. So we'll sacrifice everything for him.
A little to the right. That's good.
What's going on?
See ya.
Damage?
No, we're fine.
What just happened?
Well, I figured if we all got shot at the same time, it'd cause a system reboot.
Well, it worked.
All guards, check in.
Sector 1 is clear.
Sector 2, clear.
Sector 3 is clear.
Sector 4 is clear, dude.
I've been looking forward to this. Did you really think you could beat me all alone?
I'm not alone.
What?
Got you now, kid.
Clever. Using Ryan to take a beating while you guys got the drop on me.
Seems to be the only thing I'm good at.
Good to see your confidence growing.
Seems to be your best mission yet.
It looks like we're getting the hang of things.
Which means you're ready for bigger challenges.
Bring it on. This is how far we've come already. I can't wait to see what the future holds.
I'm glad to hear that. Let's see how you handle this.
We need to get to higher ground. Boot up!